Hey there. In order to build a strong foundation in math, it's critical that we use proper tools to enlighten our vision. I could use a little help.
The mathematical habits of mind nurture stronger, more skilled mathematicians. Applying the habits of mind enables math to be the common factor that unites us all.
Architects, engineers, and construction professionals work diligently to literally build the structures of society. They develop blueprints, assess plans of the final products, and use appropriate tools and materials to make the structures come to life. Today, we are focusing on Mathematical Habit of Mind 5, Use Appropriate Tools Strategically. The new Woody Williams Center for Advanced Learning and Careers, currently under construction, will be an innovative educational center that will prepare students for the workplace through a variety of pathways in career and technical fields. This groundbreaking education design reimagines an abandoned retail store into a career academy, showcasing technology and career education for high school students and adult education.
To help us understand how designers and contractors use appropriate tools strategically to build this building to completion, please welcome our very special guest, Construction Administrator of ZMM Architects and Engineers, Joe Doeffinger.
Thanks, Tim. It's very nice to meet you. Appreciate the opportunity and excited to show you around.
Awesome. Nice to meet you too, and it's wonderful to be here today. So looking at this building and seeing the work that's being done, there was some initial planning that took place in order to put this into action.
Yes, there was. So Cabell County Schools, they needed more space for their career technical education. So when they decided to expand, they explored a few different options. Option one was to expand their existing facility. Option two was to build a new facility. Option three, which is the one they decided to go with, was the adaptive reuse of the former Sears building, which is located here behind the mall. As a cost-effective way to use an underutilized building in the community while also bringing career and technical education close by.
That's awesome, that's awesome. Can we go check out some tools?
Oh, sure, yeah.
As we can see, underground piping is being installed here. Could you talk to us about the materials or tools being used and why they were chosen?
Yeah, sure. So there's a lot of decisions and design work that goes into underground piping. One is, you know, what is the material of the piping? What is the size of the piping? What is the capacity of it? And, you know, where is it being connected? Where is it coming from and where is it going? So is it supplying something to the building or is it taking something away from the building, such as waste or stormwater? But, you know, as you can see here, this was an existing slab. So they had to bring in tools to come in to remove the concrete. And then they had to bring in additional tools to lay the pipe. And then they had to bring in additional tools to connect the sections of the pipe.
That is fascinating and awesome. Thank you for sharing that. And can we move on and check out the rest of this site?
Oh, yeah, sure, let's go. Yep.
There are so many factors in this construction project with several different tools necessary. Could you talk to us about how cost, quality, and expertise factors into making strategic decisions about the tools and materials being used?
Yes, so as I mentioned earlier, there are a variety of decisions that architects and engineers need to consider when designing any component of the building. One thing to consider is the budget for the project. Another one to consider is the construction schedule. And another one would be what materials are readily available. So all these things need to be considered when we're in design so we can have a building that works while also meeting the owner's budget.
That is fascinating. It's really interesting to see this right now. Can't wait to see what this looks like when you're finished.
Yep.
Joe, one final thought. As an architectural engineering firm, you face many challenges that must be solved in order to complete your tasks. Could you provide advice to students and families who are facing challenges about how to use tools and resources to strategically solve their problems?
Yes. So the first part of design is understanding the problem that you're trying to solve. Once you understand the problem, you can develop a solution. And with the tools and resources, you can implement that solution.
That is awesome. Great advice. Thank you for being with us today.
Thank you very much. I enjoyed it.
As you can see, the mathematical habits of mind are applied every day in constructive ways. Everyone is a mathematician. Join us next time as we continue to explore the connections between math and the world around us. We are all math people when we nurture our skills and recognize the common factors. Let's unite with numeracy.